Okay, good morning to one and all once again. Okay, we will start the online session of OSA. Okay, we already started the unit number one, that is introduction to the operating system, in last lecture or in the last online session. Today we will continue the same, that is introduction to the operating system. I will share the slides with you. So I hope that the slide is visible to all of you. Okay. So we started with the general overview of our unit. Then we also discussed the history of the UNIX operating system. Okay. And we are in the third article, that is system structure and user's perspective. Okay, clear? Yesterday we have seen the history of the UNIX operating system. Kane Thompson and Dennis Ritchie are the two scientists, those who are responsible for design and implementation of the UNIX operating system in 1961 in Bell Labs. Okay, and later on in 1991, the Linus Torvald, who was the last year student of engineering graduation, who developed his final year project as a operating system, and it becomes a Linux operating systems. Okay, that we discussed in the history of the Unix operating systems. We discussed why Unix has become popular, what are the characteristics, what are the features of Unix operating system that make it popular. That also we discussed in the previous class. There are many features that make the Unix popular. Okay, one of the very important feature of the Unix operating system that it is designed with the help of high level language like C language. Okay, and it is having a very good user interface, which is very friendly for performing the operations. Also, Unix provides various primitives that help us to develop the complex program from the simpler program. And very important that Unix is a multi-user, multi-processor system where the number of user and the number of tasks can be executed simultaneously. That is a very important feature of Unix operating system. Okay. Then we started the history. This is the history of the Unix operating system, how it is developed and how the changes are take place. In 1969 it is started, then in 1971 some editors like ROF and ED are added. In 1973 again the portable change take place in the Unix operating systems. So these are the changes or the history of the Unix operating systems. Okay, here in this slide we have summarized all these things, that Ken Thompson and Dennis Ritchie, how they started their project in 1979, okay, 69. And then how Dennis Ritchie helps Ken Thompson with the C compiler to write the Unix kernel, okay. And lastly, the very important point is that the Linux operating system was developed by Linus Torvald in 1991, okay. So this also we discuss the architecture of the Unix operating system. It is a layer architecture. It is also called as the overview of the Unix operating system, where you can see the hardware is at center. Okay, hardware is at center, and then the second layer is the kernel layer. Kernel, as I said, kernel is the operating system. Kernel is the heart of any operating system that provides various services to the computer, to the hardware, to the user, and to other resources also. So kernel is itself is nothing but the operating system. And then the third layer, there are various commands and program that can be executed, like sh stand for shell, who is the who command, a.out is the executable file of the C program, date command, wc stand for word count, grep is the command we use for filtering, ed is the editor, vi is the editor. So like this, these are all the commands or the programs which can be executed on the operating system. Okay, that comes at third layer. And the last layer of the architecture is nothing but the other application program. So other application program means what software you are installing on the operating system or on your machine that can be executed on this layer, in this layer. Like here it is explained, the CC stand for the C compiler, which can be installed and executed. Okay, so like this, the other program which are installed by the user, so mostly it is called as the end user. End user means you are an end user. I am an end user of my system. You are an end user of your system. So you can directly communicate with your operating system at this layer. So how many layers are there? There are total, you can see, hardware is the first layer. Kernel is the second layer. These commands and the programs are the third layer. And other application programs and the user comes at the fourth layer. So there are total four layers. Layer zero is what? Layer zero is hardware layer. Layer one is kernel layer. Then the layer two is this commands and operations. And layer four is this other application program. Okay. So you keep in mind all these layers. Layer zero is the hardware layer. Keep in your mind. Okay. Layer zero is the hardware layer. Layer one is the kernel layer. Then comes layer two. Then comes layer three. Okay. Like this. So if I ask that what is at layer three, which is the outermost layer, which is the outermost layer of the Unix architecture, then you can say that the other application program or the end user is communicated at the outermost layer, which is the innermost layer of the Unix operating system. So innermost layer is nothing but the hardware. Okay, like this. So yesterday I said that when we purchased the laptop, okay, so hardware is there, only hardware, motherboard is there, and then we, so that hardware is nothing but layer zero. Innermost layer is the hardware. And then we install the operating system on that laptop. So that is nothing but kernel. Okay. Remember, student, you keep in your mind that kernel is the operating system. Okay. Kernel is not any different thing. Kernel is itself is the operating system. Okay. Kernel provides various services which are similar to the operating system. So here in our subject, many times whenever we come across the kernel, kernel itself is the operating system. So hum kya karte hai ki hamare laptop mein hardware rehta hai, motherboard rehta hai. So we install the operating system, that is nothing but the kernel, and then the kernel is having various commands. Operating system is having various commands or the programs like sh, who, a dot out, date. Various commands and programs are there of that operating system which can come across this layer. And then in the innermost layer we installed our software. Aap kya karte hai ki aap usme C program ka compiler install karte, Java ka compiler install karte, Python install karte. So that comes at the outermost layer of any operating system. Clear? So this thing we have discussed yesterday also. So now see the next article's perspective. So user's perspective is nothing but what are the high level features of Unix operating system. So high level features, very three important parameters or the points comes there. That is, first is nothing but the file system. Okay, then the processing environment and the building block primitives. Okay, so these three you keep in your mind, that whenever the user's perspective or somebody can ask you that what are the high level features of Unix operating system, then there are three features of Unix operating system, that is the file system, the processing environment, and the building block primitives. We will see one by one each of these features. So what is the file system? So as yesterday also we discussed the file system, Unix file system is characterized by these six characteristics. So these six characteristics are there on your screen. You can see the first characteristic is that the Unix file system is hierarchical in nature or hierarchical in structure. Okay, what do you mean by hierarchical? So it is like this. A sample file system is shown in this figure. Okay, everybody see the figure clearly. So it is a hierarchical in nature, means it is tree structure. Hierarchical means a root node is there, then the sub node is there, and then sub to sub node is there, and lastly the leaf node is there. So it becomes a tree structure. That is called as a hierarchical structure. Okay, clear to everybody? So that's why the very first characteristics of Unix operating system or the file system is that it is characterized by the slides are not visible to you. Okay. I will share it. Okay. Yes. So see, the Unix file system is characterized by the hierarchical structure. Okay. The hierarchical structure means it is like this. Okay. See, this is the hierarchical structure of the Unix file system. The hierarchical structure is like this, where you can see the root node is there. The root node is nothing but the root of the tree. Editor, that root is given by slash. So here you can see the slash is given. Slash means what? Slash is the root node of that file system. Root node. You keep this sentence or these words in your mind and note it, that every file system start with the root node, and then there is a sub nodes. We called it as a child node or the subdirectories. Okay. And then there is a sub to sub directories, and lastly there is a leaf node where the files are connected or the files are stored. So this is the sample file system tree. Very important that you need to remember that this is hierarchical in nature. Hierarchical means the hierarchy is there. A root node is there, non leaf node is there, a leaf node is there, like this. And second characteristic is that it is characterized by consistent treatment of file data. So consistent means regularly the file system is performing every operation on the file data. That is nothing but the consistent treatment of file data. File system is responsible for performing the operation on the file data. Okay, so continuously some operation is going on whenever the file is active. Okay, whenever the file is executable, then the operations are performed on file data. Third characteristics, you can see ability to create and delete file. It is the responsibility or it is a task of the file system that it can create the file as well as it can delete the files. So ability to create the file and delete the file. Then next one is dynamic growth of the file. So it dynamic growth means how the file size can be increased. That is nothing but the dynamic growth of the files. The file system is responsible for dynamic growth of the files. Protection of the file data. So every you created one file, very important file, you want to protect that file from others, then that protection to that file is given by file system. Then next one is treatment of peripheral devices as a file. Whenever a peripheral devices means what? Whenever we connect a printer, whenever we connect a scanner, whenever we connect a pen drive, or we connect a web camera, or we connect any peripheral device, any external devices is connected to your system, then that is treated as a file. Clear to everybody? So all these are nothing but the characteristics of Unix file system. The file system plays a very important role in each and every operating system. Always keep in mind, file system plays a very important role in each and every operating system, whether it is a Unix operating system or you see the Windows operating system or Mac OS, Android OS, iOS, any operating system, whatever the operating system is there, a file system is always there that plays the important role. Okay, and these are the characteristics of that file system, that it is hierarchical in nature. It characterized by consistent treatment of the file data. It is having the ability to create and delete the files, and it is responsible for dynamic growth of the files, and it protect the file data and the treatment of the peripheral devices as the files. Now lastly, on this slide you can read the statement is written there. The file system is organized as a tree with a single root node called root, written as slash. Okay, this is a very very important statement. A file system is organized tree with single root node called root, written as slash. Every non leaf node of the file system structure is a directory and files at leaf nodes of the tree are either directories, regular file or special file, special device file. So what is the meaning of this? You can see this is a sample file structure is shown on your screen, where every file system is organized and it starts with the root node. That is called as the root of the file system. And it is written at slash. And then it comes the non-leaf node. Non-leaf nodes are nothing but the directories. Okay, so here you can see on your screen, the figure is shown. The slash is nothing but the root node. And this the second layer is nothing but the non-leaf node. This is what? This is a directory. And then the leaf node is a file. Or sometimes the leaf node is a regular file, or sometimes the leaf node is the special device file. So yesterday, during the practical hours, I explained you the terminal command. I explained you the terminal command. Okay. Do you remember that terminal command, TTY command? We discussed in the practical session, OSL lab, the first Unix command, that is TTY. Okay. Yesterday in the afternoon session, we discussed that. So here you can see, okay. See here, now in the figure, you can see there is a non-leaf node, that is dev. Dev stand for, dev is the directory. It is a device, okay. And under that device folder or device directory, there are two files. I have shown you. Maine aapko kal dikhaya tha. Ye dev folder slash dev slash pts, and then under pts there are 0 1 2 3, how many terminal window we open, that many files are runtimely created. It is runtime. Once your terminal is closed, then that file is automatically deleted. So that is called as the runtime creation of the file. So that device file, that means nothing but the terminal. Here it can you can see in your figure that the root node is there, slash dev, slash dev, slash ka matlab kya hai? Slash is nothing but the root node. Dev ka matlab kya hai? Dev is the device directory. Root pe kya hai? Root pe aapki device naam ki directory hai. Aur device directory mein kya hai? Device directory mein aapke do files hai, tty00, tty01. So in order to understand the file system structure, आपको यह याद रखना पड़ेगा कि एवरी फाइल सिस्टम स्टार्टेड विथ रूट नोड दैट इज रिटन एज स्लैश. क्लियर टू एवरीबडी? देन एवरी फाइल सिस्टम इज हैविंग नॉन लीफ नोड दैट इज कॉल्ड एज डायरेक्टरी. एवरी फाइल सिस्टम इज हैविंग अ लीफ नोड. लीफ नोड कैन बी अ डायरेक्टरी, कैन बी अ रेगुलर फाइल, कैन बी अ स्पेशल डिवाइस फाइल. ओके, गॉट इट? Okay, everybody clear with this concept? Now tell me, anybody can tell me that what is the date? What is the in your figure, what is the date? Date is a file, or date is a directory, or date is a root? Tell me what is mean by date. See the figure carefully. What is the date? ओके, यहाँ पे मैंने आपको यहाँ पे पॉइंट आउट करता हूं, मैं यहाँ पे डेट इज शोन इन दिस फाइल स्ट्रक्चर, देर इज द डेट. सिमिलरली इज द sh इज देर, sh who. सो व्हाट इज दिस? दिस इज द डायरेक्टरी, और दिस इज द फाइल, और दिस इज द डिवाइस फाइल, दिस इज द रेगुलर फाइल, स्पेशल फाइल, क्या है? दिस इज द फाइल, करेक्ट, वेरी गुड. ओके, यस, एब्सोल्युटली राइट, दिस इज द फाइल, बिकॉज it follows our convention, it comes at leaf node. It comes at leaf node. Whatever is at leaf node is a file. It may be directory, it may be device file, it may be regular file. See here, and direct, my dear student, keep in mind, directory is the special file. Directory is also known as a special file. Ek cheez aapko ye yaad rakhne padegi ki directory many times is called as a special file. Okay, डायरेक्टरी को हम स्पेशल फाइल भी कहते हैं. देन डिवाइस फाइल इज देयर, रेगुलर फाइल्स आर देयर. सो व्हाट एवर इट कम्स एट लीफ नोड दैट इज नथिंग बट द फाइल. वेरी गुड. एंड नाउ टेल मी व्हाट इज बीन? व्हाट इज द बीन? बीन इज द डायरेक्टरी, और बीन इज द फाइल? Bean is a directory or bean is a file. Correct. Very good. Bean is the directory. Bean is the directory. Okay. So it comes because it is a non-leaf node. Correct. 100% correct. You are absolutely right. This is the directory. It comes in a non-leaf node. That's why it is a directory. Okay. So I hope that everybody understood this file system structure. It always start with root node. Root node is called as the root that is written as slash. Then comes the non-leaf node, and the leaf node is nothing but the special directories, files, regular files, and the special device file. Okay. Now, one more very interesting concept is there. That is nothing but the name of the file. Okay. Here, one more very concept, important concept, that is nothing but the name of the file. Before that, you can see the here in this slide, the program in the Unix system have no knowledge of the internal format in which the kernel stores the file data. Yes, treating the data as an unformatted stream of bytes. Okay, means program means what? Program means whatever the program which we are executing in the Unix. That program is not having any information about internal format of the file data. Okay, that is this program is always considering or always treating that data as an unformatted stream of bytes. Okay, so what is the meaning of this statement? I will tell you that whenever we are executing the program, now in the first year or in the first semester also, you executed many programs, C program. क्या करते हैं, सी प्रोग्राम टाइप करते हैं, सेव करते हैं और एग्जीक्यूट करते हैं. सो व्हेनेवर द प्रोग्राम इज एग्जीक्यूटेड, दैट प्रोग्राम इज नॉट हैविंग एनी नॉलेज अबाउट द इंटरनल फॉर्मेट ऑफ द फाइल डेटा. ओके, समझ में आया आपको? प्रोग्राम आपने रन किया मैट्रिक्स मल्टीप्लीकेशन, तो मैट्रिक्स मल्टीप्लीकेशन प्रोग्राम रन किया, तो दैट प्रोग्राम इज नॉट हैविंग एनी इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द हाउ द इंटरनली द डेटा इज स्टोर्ड. ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम में फाइल का डेटा इंटरनली किस फॉर्मेट में स्टोर है, दैट इंफॉर्मेशन और दैट नॉलेज इज नॉट नोन टू द प्रोग्राम. प्रोग्राम इज जस्ट एग्जीक्यूटेड एंड व्हाट इट इज कंसिडरिंग, इट कंसिडर दैट द फाइल डेटा एज अ अनफॉर्मेटेड स्ट्रीम ऑफ बाइट. अनफॉर्मेटेड स्ट्रीम ऑफ बाइट, इसका मतलब क्या है? अनफॉर्मेटेड स्ट्रीम ऑफ बाइट मतलब, तो स्ट्रीम ऑफ बाइट का मतलब क्या है कि नाउ एवरी फाइल इज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय मीन ऑफ बाइट्स. बिट्स आर देयर, 0 1 आर द बिट्स, देन द नंबर ऑफ बाइट्स आर देयर. ओके, सो 0 0 1 1 1 0 1 0 कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ 0 0, सो दैट इज नथिंग बट अ अनफॉर्मेटेड स्ट्रीम ऑफ बाइट. प्रोग्राम डोंट नो एनी इंफॉर्मेशन और इंटरनल इंफॉर्मेशन ऑफ द इंटरनल फॉर्मेट ऑफ द फाइल डेटा. इट ओनली कंसिडर दैट डेटा एज एन unformatted stream of byte. Okay, then you can see the next line, the program may interpret the byte stream as they wish, but the interpretation has no bearing on how the operating system stores the data. Now, whenever we execute the program can interpret the byte stream as they wish. According to their wish, the program or the data can be interpreted, but this interpretation has no bearing on how the operating system stores the data. So these are some of the characteristics or the information about the file data, how your program treat with the your file data. So here you only remember that the program treat the internal data as an unformatted stream of byte, okay, as per their wish. Okay, then next paragraph you can see, directories are like a regular file. In this respect, the systems treat the data in the directory as a byte stream. Okay, so जैसे मैंने अभी कहा था आपको कि directories are a file, it is a special file, or it is like a regular file. Directories are like a regular file. If we are saying that it is a regular file, then the system, that means the operating system treats the data in the directory as a byte stream. डायरेक्टरी में जो कुछ डेटा आपने स्टोर किया है, दैट विल बी ट्रीटेड एज अ बाइट स्ट्रीम. व्हाई इट विल बी ट्रीटेड एज अ बाइट स्ट्रीम? बिकॉज इन द प्रीवियस पैराग्राफ वी हैव सीन That program treat the internal data as an unformatted byte stream. और byte stream का मतलब मैंने आपको बताया, byte stream is the combination of the bits 0001111110000 like this, you know the binary bits are there. So internally the data is treated as this unformatted byte stream. So ultimately the directory will be treated as a byte stream. But the data contains the name of the file in the directory in a predictable format so that the operating system and the program such as ls command can discover the file in directory. Okay, that ls command I will show you in the practical hours. Ls is the list of the directories and the files. Okay, then you can see there permission to access the file is controlled by access permission associated with the file. To the user, the Unix system treats the device file as they were the file. Okay, so this means three things you have to remember here in this slide, that the program is not having any knowledge about the internal format of the file data. The program treats the file data as an unformatted byte stream. This is the first thing. Second thing, the program also treat the directory as a regular file. So the system treat the data in the directory as a byte stream. Okay, and third thing, the permission to access the file is controlled by access permission associated with the file. So access permission means the read permission, write permission, executable permission. So these are the access permission. Every file is having a permission associated with that file. Okay, so these are some important points about the file system. We will move towards our next slide. And these are some of the key points that are very important you have to remember with respect to the file system or the file system structure. So you can see that there is the first point is the root. Every file system is having a root. Har file system ki shuruaat kahan se hogi? Root se hogi. Or root is nothing but the root node of that file system. It is written by slash. Ye cheez aapko har baar hamesha yaad rakhni hai. ओके, दिस आर सम की पॉइंट्स. मैंने क्या किया है कि फाइल सिस्टम के बारे में जो की पॉइंट्स है उनको समराइज किया है यहाँ पे. सो रूट, सो इफ आई आस्क यू दैट व्हाट इज द रूट ऑफ द फाइल सिस्टम, देन यू कैन इजीली से दैट रूट इज द रूट नोड ऑफ द फाइल सिस्टम वेयर ऑल द फाइल्स आर स्टोर्ड. वहां से शुरुआत होती है फाइल की एंड इट इज रिटन एज स्लैश. देन सेकंड पॉइंट यू कैन रीड देयर अ नॉन लीफ नोड इज द डायरेक्टरी ऑफ द फाइल्स. That we seen. Third point you can read there. The file at the leaf node are directories or a regular file or special device file. ये भी चीज मैंने आपको बताई. The file at the root node is the directory or the regular file or the special device file. Now the next point is path name. What do you mean by path name? See here. Right now we know that every file is having a name. Every file is having a name. Okay. So, आप जब फाइल बनाते हैं तो उसको आप नाम देते हैं. जैसे कि आपने सिर्फ मैट्रिक्स का प्रोग्राम बनाया तो आप उसको क्या नाम देंगे? मैट्रिक्स डॉट सी फॉर एग्जाम्पल. ओके, ऐसा आपने उसको नाम दिया. सो हियर दिस नेम विल बी आइडेंटिफाइड बाय यूजर. आपको मालूम है कि उसका नाम क्या है? मैट्रिक्स डॉट सी है. और मैं आपको कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन माई सेंटेंस. एवरीबडी कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन माई सेंटेंस. आपने एक प्रोग्राम बनाया, उसको आपने सेव किया और उसको आपने नाम दिया मैट्रिक्स डॉट सी. सो दिस इज द नेम ऑफ द फाइल. दिस इज द नेम ऑफ द फाइल फॉर यूजर. आप क्या करेंगे कि आप बताएंगे यस माई फाइल नेम इज मैट्रिक्स डॉट सी. लेकिन डियर स्टूडेंट, नाउ दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट. आप ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम पढ़ रहे हैं, आपको अभी ये पढ़ना है, ये समझ में लेना है कि ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम को एक्सेस करने के लिए फाइल, हाउ ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम ट्रीट्स द फाइल. ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम उस फाइल को किस नाम से जानता है. मेरा कहने का मतलब समझ में आया आपको कि मैट्रिक्स डॉट सी इज द नेम ऑफ द फाइल. This is for you. But on the other hand, there is operating system. Operating system ko bhi file ka naam chahiye. So operating system file ka naam matrix.c aisa consider nahi karta hai. The operating system treat the name of the file as the path name. Very important, path name. Okay, path name. ये word आपके लिए नया होगा. Path name is a new word to you. But what is the path name? Path name, the name of the file given by path name. Okay, that describes how to locate the file in the file system hierarchy. Okay, क्या बताया मैंने आपको कि name of the file is given by path name. That describes how to locate the file in the file system hierarchy. So every file name is having a path name. Operating system will access the file with respect to the path name. And that is nothing but that describes how to locate the file in the file hierarchy. Locate का मतलब क्या है कि आपका फाइल का लोकेशन कहाँ पे है और ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम को वो फाइल अभी एक्सेस करनी है, एग्जीक्यूट करनी है. तो ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम विल ट्रीट दैट फाइल अकॉर्डिंग टू इट्स लोकेशन स्टोर्ड इन द फाइल हायरार्की. तो ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम डायरेक्टली मैट्रिक्स डॉट सी ऐसा ये एक्सेस नहीं करेगा. ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम क्या करेगा? Operating system locate that file in the file hierarchy. And how it will be located? How it will be located? It will be located from the slash root node slash. Suppose slash is there, then the subdirectory is there. Like for example, slash is the root node. Then aapne root node pe ek directory banayi aapke naam se. Suppose XYZ slash XYZ, then slash matrix dot C. So it is like this. So operating system treat the file name as a path name. It describes how to locate the file in the file hierarchy. Got it? Everybody got it? What is the path name? Path name. So see, I will show you the figure. Okay, this figure we know. Okay. And here I want to access the file. I want to access the file date.c. Okay, everybody see date.c. So how I can access the how the operating system can access this file? What is the path name of this file? So the path name of this file, yahan pe main abhi chat box mein likhta hu. The path name of the file starts from the root, then usr. User, then src, then cmd slash then date.c, date.c. So here you can see in the chat box. Okay, I have written one message slash usr slash src slash cmd slash date.c is the path name of that file. Got it? Everybody clear? So aap dekh sakte hai, you can check. I started with the root node. Root is nothing but the slash. Then we are having one directory, that is a usr. We are having one more directory under usr, that is a src. We are having one more directory under that, there is a cmd. And under cmd, I am having that file date.c. So this is the path name of that file. Okay. So may I ask you, is it clear to everybody? What is the path name? Yes. All the students. Very good. So this is the path name is a very important concept. The file name is given by the path name that describe how the file is located in the file hierarchy. So har bar aap jahan kahi bhi aapka file save karte locate karte, so the path name is given. So suppose now I will ask you, what is the path name of this password file, passwd? How you can write the passwd? Slash etc slash pass. Very good. Okay. This Gauru has written in the chat box slash etc slash pass w plus wd. So that is what, that is the path name. That is the path name of this password file. Okay. So this is a very interesting point. And जैसे मैंने कहा अभी कि matrix.c ये आपके लिए मेरे लिए आपने फाइल का नाम दिया matrix.c, बट अभी हम पढ़ रहे हैं ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम कर्नल. कर्नल जब वो फाइल को एक्सेस करेगा तो कर्नल के लिए वो पाथ नेम चाहिए. कर्नल रिक्वायर्स द पाथ नेम एंड स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द रूट नोड. ओके, रूट इज नथिंग बट द स्लैश. ओके, एंड देन द डायरेक्टरी, देन द स्लैश, देन द सब डायरेक्टरी, देन स्लैश एंड देन द नेम ऑफ द फाइल. सो दैट इज द पाथ नेम. तो यहाँ पे एक चीज आई वुड लाइक टू शेयर विद यू द एग्जैक्ट डेफिनेशन ऑफ द पाथ नेम. सो व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द पाथ नेम? यू सी द पाथ नेम इज द सीक्वेंस ऑफ कॉम्पोनेंट. पाथ नेम इज द सीक्वेंस ऑफ कॉम्पोनेंट नेम सेपरेटेड बाय स्लैश कैरेक्टर. ओके, पाथ नेम इज द सीक्वेंस ऑफ कॉम्पोनेंट नेम सेपरेटेड बाय स्लैश कैरेक्टर. हम क्या करते हैं उस कॉम्पोनेंट नेम को सेपरेट करते हैं स्लैश देकर. एंड अ कॉम्पोनेंट इज अ सीक्वेंस ऑफ कैरेक्टर दैट डिजिग्नेट द फाइल नेम दैट इज यूनिकली कंटेन इन द प्रीवियस डायरेक्टरी. ओके, सो दिस थिंग आई विल एक्सप्लेन. आपने just a minute, I will give you the exact definition in the chat box. Just a minute. I will type that definition in the chat window. Okay. So here I shared with you the exact definition of the path name. That is, path name is the sequence of component name separated by slash character, where the component is the sequence of characters that designate the file name that uniquely contained in the previous directory component. Okay, previous directory component. So you can note that is available in the book, but this is very important to understand that what is the path name. Path name is the sequence of components that separated by the slash, and the component is the sequence of characters that designate the file name that is uniquely contained in the previous directory component. Okay, clear to everybody? So one more thing is there, a full path name start with slash character and specifies the file that can be found by starting at the file system root and traversing in the file tree. following the branches that lead to successive components name of the path name. Okay, so a full path name always starts from the root. A full path name always starts from the root. So that is a very important part. And that right now you have given the correct answer, that is /etc/passwd is the one of the path name for passwd. Then I have also given you the example of one file, that /etc/usr. Okay, this /usr/src/cmd/ this is a this message I have shared with you again. /usr/src/cmd/date.c is the complete full path name. Okay, now this is the path name. Path name is clear to everybody, or there is any doubt or question in your minds? If anybody is having problem to understand the path name, ask your problem or ask your doubt questions so that we can clarify. Okay, do you have any problem with respect to path name? Anybody is having doubts or any problem, difficulty to understand the path name concept? I hope that everybody will clear with this path name. So I now move to the next point, that is current directory. So what is the current directory? Current directory means now path name is having slash, that is, I think about the directory slash, many example diya tha, /usr/src/cmd/date.c. So current directory is what? Path name does not have to start from the root, but can be designated relative to the current directory of an existing process by omitting the initial slash in the path name. Okay, so current directory means the directory in which actually we are working. Current directory, present directory, usko alag naam bhi de sakte hai, present directory, which is my present working directory. So there is a command in your Linux, that is a pwd. Pwd stand for present working directory, current working directory. So current working directory in which I am working, or the actually right now the process is continued in that current directory, that is the current directory. Okay, so in this example, which is the current directory? Suppose this message I shared, which is the current directory? See, I shared the message once again. This, tell me which is the current directory in this path name. Siddhant is saying CMD, correct? Very good. So currently we are working in CMD. Okay, so that's why the current working directory or the present working directory is CMD. So that point you make it clear that a current directory is very important, ki jisme aapka kaam chal raha hai. So here in this path name, the current working directory is CMD. Correct. Then comes the point directory, that everybody knows the directory. What is the directory? Directory is a special file which contain the files. Directories means these are like a regular files, okay, and which contains the n number of files. So whenever in practical hours we will see one command ls. So ls is the stand for list of the directories and the files. Okay, then access permission. As I said, every file is having the access permission. The permissions are like a read, write and execute permission. So and every file is having three types of owner. This is also a very important concept here. Every file is having three types of owner. So how many owners are there? First of all, I will tell you the file owner. A file owner here. File owner. First one is file owner, then second one is the file group owner. File group owner. And The third one is the others. Okay. See here, मैंने चैट बॉक्स में तीन मैसेज आपको शेयर किया अभी. दिस आर नथिंग बट द ओनर ऑफ द फाइल्स और द यूजर्स ऑफ द फाइल. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द यूजर्स ऑफ द फाइल. टाइप्स ऑफ द यूजर. टाइप्स ऑफ द यूजर. आपने एक फाइल बनाई मैट्रिक्स डॉट सी. मैट्रिक्स डॉट सी इज द फाइल एंड दिस फाइल इज हैविंग थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ यूजर. फर्स्ट यूजर इज द ओनर, कि जिसने फाइल बनाई. ओके, द फर्स्ट यूजर इज द ओनर हु क्रिएटेड द फाइल. दैट्स व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज ओनर. सेकंड यूजर इज द फाइल ग्रुप ओनर. उसका मतलब क्या है? सी हियर, व्हेनेवर यू क्रिएट द फाइल मैट्रिक्स डॉट सी, देन इट इज ग्रुप अंडर अ पर्टिकुलर कैटेगरी. सो देर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ग्रुप्स. Okay, group 1, group 2, group 3, group 4. So group 1 में आपके चार फाइल है, group 2 में आपके चार फाइल है, group 5 में आपके पांच फाइल है. So like there are different types of groups. In a Unix operating system, there are different types of groups. ये सब मैं आपको practical में command use करके दिखाने वाला हूँ. So second user is a group owner. And third type is what? Others. Others मतलब आपने मैट्रिक्स डॉट सी ए प्रोग्राम बनाया. यू आर द ओनर ऑफ दैट फाइल, बट अदर कैन ऑल्सो यूज दैट फाइल. यस और नो? अदर योर फ्रेंड, सो योर टीचर, एनीबडी कैन यूज दैट फाइल. सो दैट मीन्स थर्ड टाइप ऑफ यूजर इज द अदर यूजर. समझ में आया आपको? इज इट क्लियर टू एवरीबडी? This is also a very important point to remember that each file is having three types of user. First one is file owner, second one is group owner, and third one is others. Okay, so this is nothing but the types of the user. Types of the users. User. So in chat box I have written, what is this? This is the types of the users. Now one more thing is there, the access permission to the user. So what are the access permission? Are nothing but three types of access permission. First one is read, second one is write, and third one is execute. Okay, so that three access permission I have written in the chat box. These are what? Types of access permissions. Okay, see, very important point with respect to the file system. Every file is having three types of user, and each file is having three types of access permission. So first access permission is read, second one is write, and third one is execute. Read, write, execute. So that is access permission. Clear to everybody? So my question to you now, who can read the file? Means which type of user can read the file? All user. Correct. Very good. Siddhant has given a correct answer. All user can read the file. Who can write the file? Second question. Who can write the data in the file? Owner of the file. Correct. Absolutely right. The owner of the file and the group owner also. Keep in mind, a group owner can also having a write permission. Group owner is also having write permission, but others are not having permission to write the data. Others are not having the permission to write in that file. And execute, same thing. Owner and the group owner can execute, but other cannot execute the file. आपको उनको एक्सेस देना है नहीं देना है आपको डिसाइड करना है. यू कैन चेंज द एक्सेस राइट. देर इज अ कमांड इन लिनक्स, देर इज अ कमांड टू चेंज द एक्सेस राइट. ये सब मैं आपको प्रैक्टिकल में बताने वाला हूँ. ओके, सो देर इज अ कमांड टू चेंज द एक्सेस राइट ऑल्सो. समझ में आया आपको? सो दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट ऑफ आवर डिस्कशन दैट फाइल इज हैविंग थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ यूजर, the owner of the file, the group owner of the file and the author, and each file is having three types of access permissions. First one is the read permission, second one is the write permission, and third one is the execute permission. Okay, so I hope that this is clear to everybody. Now next point is a program of copy of file. Now here I will show you one slide where you can see the program. Here is your sample program for copy a file. फाइल कॉपी करने के लिए एक सी प्रोग्राम. सो राइट नाउ यू डोंट बॉदर अबाउट द सिंटैक्स एंड सिमेंटिक्स. ये जो कुछ प्रिमिटिव्स एंड कमांड्स यहाँ पे आपको दिखाई दे रहे हैं, यू डोंट बॉदर अबाउट दैट. वी आर हैविंग वन प्रोग्राम इन आवर असाइनमेंट्स, कॉपी क्रिएट द फाइल, डिलीट द फाइल, कॉपी द फाइल. देयर वी आर गोइंग टू यूज दिस ऑल कॉन्सेप्ट्स. सो दिस इज अ सैम्पल प्रोग्राम इन यूनिक्स टू कॉपी अ फाइल. ओके, सो कॉपी मीन्स कंटेंट ऑफ वन फाइल इज कॉपीड टू द अनदर फाइल. तो आपने क्या किया कि एक प्रीवियस फाइल इज एक्स वाई जेड एंड यू वॉन्ट टू कॉपी द कंटेंट ऑफ एक्स वाई जेड टू द ए बी सी, देन यू कैन यूज द कॉपी कमांड. सो देर इज अ कॉपी कमांड इन लिनक्स, देर इज अ कॉपी कमांड. इट इज नथिंग बट द सीपी. सीपी स्टैंड फॉर कॉपी. सो कॉपी ओल्ड फाइल एंड न्यू फाइल. सिंटैक्स इज लाइक दिस, कॉपी ओल्ड कॉमा न्यू. A program is there, the content of old file can be copied to the new file. Okay, so that we will discuss. Right now you don't bother about this. So this is a sample program is given about this file copy. Okay, next point is nothing but, now the next high level features of the file is the processing environment. Okay, what we discuss right now, we discuss the file system structure. File system structure ke bare mein humne dekha ki these are the characteristics of file system, and then this is the sample tree structure. These are some of the characteristics again related to the program, unformatted stream of bytes, directories, and the access permission. These are again a keywords or key points with respect to this file system structure. And this is a sample program for copy the file. And now the next point is the processing environment, the next high level feature of Unix is processing environment. So what is the processing environment? Okay, see here, a program is an executable file. Okay, a program is an executable file. Jab aap kehte hai ki maine program banaya matrix.c, so that is what, that is a executable file. आप एक सेंटेंस यहां पे पढ़ सकते हैं, अ प्रोग्राम इज जस्ट अ फाइल टू द यूनिक्स. ओके, आपने प्रोग्राम बनाया तो इट बिकम अ फाइल एंड इट इट ट्रीट एज अ फाइल टू द यूनिक्स. इट इट इज लाइक जस्ट अ फाइल टू द यूनिक्स. ओके, इन अदर वर्ड्स, व्हेन अ यूजर क्रिएट अ सोर्स प्रोग्राम एंड देन कंपाइल इट, द प्रोग्राम रिसाइड्स ऑन द डिस्क एज एन एग्जीक्यूटेबल फाइल. सेकंड सेंटेंस, फर्स्ट सेंटेंस क्या बताया मैंने, अ प्रोग्राम, आपने मैट्रिक्स डॉट सी का प्रोग्राम बनाया, मैट्रिक्स डॉट सी इज जस्ट अ फाइल टू द यूनिक्स. क्लियर टू एवरीबडी? सेकंड सेंटेंस क्या बताया हमें, इन अदर वर्ड्स, वेन एवर द यूजर क्रिएट द सोर्स प्रोग्राम एंड कंपाइल द प्रोग्राम रिसाइड्स ऑन द डिस्क एज एन एग्जीक्यूटेबल फाइल. आपने प्रोग्राम बनाया मैट्रिक्स डॉट सी, आपने उसको एग्जीक्यूट किया, कंपाइल किया, then it become a executable file. Second sentence समझ में आया आपको? It becomes a executable file. Third sentence अभी देखो, the term process is used to describe the program that is actually running within the preview of the Unix. That is a spelling mistake is there. That is a preview of the Unix. Process is the program which is actually running in the Unix operating systems. So, मैं आपको ये तीन चीजें आपको बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. फर्स्ट वन इज प्रोग्राम आपने बनाया, प्रोग्राम इज द फाइल टू द यूनिक्स, फिर आपने प्रोग्राम कंपाइल किया, एग्जीक्यूट किया, सो इट बिकम अ एग्जीक्यूटेबल फाइल, एंड वेन एवर द प्रोग्राम इज एग्जीक्यूटिंग, आपका प्रोग्राम एग्जीक्यूट हो रहा है, रनिंग, वेन एवर द प्रोग्राम इज एक्चुअली रनिंग, तो उसे क्या कहते हैं, उसे कहते हैं प्रोसेस. प्रोसेस इज अ इंस्टेंस ऑफ प्रोग्राम विच इज इन एग्जीक्यूशन. समझ में आया आपको? प्रोसेस इज द इंस्टेंस ऑफ प्रोग्राम विच इज इन एग्जीक्यूशन. ये दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट टू बी नोट दैट व्हाट इज अ प्रोसेस. प्रोसेस इज द इंस्टेंस ऑफ प्रोग्राम विच इज इन एग्जीक्यूशन. ओके, कितने लोगों को समझ में आया ये पॉइंट, व्हाट इज द प्रोसेस, व्हाट इज द प्रोसेस? यस प्रथमेश, प्रोसेस इज द इंस्टेंस ऑफ प्रोग्राम विच इज इन एग्जीक्यूशन. आपका मैट्रिक्स डॉट सी, मैट्रिक्स डॉट सी आपने बनाया, सो इट बिकम अ फाइल टू द यूनिक्स. मैट्रिक्स डॉट सी आपने कंपाइल किया, सो इट बिकम अ एग्जीक्यूटेबल फाइल. मैट्रिक्स डॉट सी आपका प्रोग्राम आप रन कर रहे, सो इट बिकम अ प्रोसेस. क्लियर टू एवरीबडी? क्लियर? दिस इज अ प्रोसेस. यस मीनिंग मीन्स रनिंग प्रोग्राम इन करेक्ट, वेरी एब्सोल्युटली राइट, एब्सोल्युटली राइट व्हाट सिद्धांत इज सेइंग. इट्स अ रनिंग प्रोग्राम इन द सिस्टम. यस whatever is in execution, whatever is under running stage, that is a process. ye aapko hamesha yaad rakhna hai. This is very important point as per as your operating system and computer engineering is concerned. koi bhi aapko puchega what is mean by process, so process is the instance of program which is in execution. जो कुछ रन हो रहा है उसे आपको प्रोसेस कहना पड़ेगा. क्लियर? ओके, तो वहां पे एग्जांपल दिया है अभी ना उन्होंने. नेक्स्ट वन देयर इज एग्जांपल. फॉर एग्जांपल, व्हेन अ यूजर रिक्वेस्ट दैट द प्रोग्राम बी रन इन यूनिक्स, यूनिक्स मस्ट लोड द प्रोग्राम फ्रॉम एग्जीक्यूटेबल फाइल ऑन द डिस्क वेयर इट रिसाइड्स, बिल्ड अ एप्रोप्रिएट डेटा स्ट्रक्चर टू कीप द ट्रैक ऑफ दैट प्रोग्राम एज इट रन, and then starts it running to the Unix. Then the process is just the data structure in which the Unix keeps all the information about the status of the program that is running. Okay, so the second paragraph explain about how the process is executing. Means aapne program banaya matrix.c, to wo kahan pe store rahega? Wo hard disk pe store hai. Hard disk is nothing but the disk. Okay, so executable file is stored on the disk. तो जब आपको वो run करना है तो program कहाँ पे आएगा? Memory में आएगा. कौन लाएगा वो? Operating system will brought that program from disk to memory. And whenever the program brought into the memory, then it become process. So operating system treat it as a data structure and perform all the operation right from its execution till the termination. Clear to everybody? So that is a very important point of our system, operating system. So I stop here now, okay, because our time is finished. Okay, I will stop my session and will appeal you to fill that Google sheet. Okay, see here, the Google sheet is there, all roll numbers are there. You those who are present kindly put P. अभी मैंने वहां पे आज की डेट भी डाली है. द शीट नंबर वन, शीट नंबर वन में आपको आज की डेट दिखाई देंगी. आपका नाम रोल नंबर वहां पे है. आपके नाम के रोल नंबर के सामने आपको प्रेजेंट मतलब पी करना है. दैट इज नथिंग बट यूर अटेंडेंस. क्लियर टू एवरीबडी? सो आई स्टॉप माई सेशन. थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग. गुड डे. मार्क द अटेंडेंस.